Hi, this is Dr. Pann, and we're going to go over assignment number 6, which is the non-parametric assignment, and go through two of the data sets that you're required to analyze for this assignment. Again, going to go through an overview, do some of the stats, and address some of the issues, but still leave some of the work, obviously, up to you. So for the first part of the assignment, we're challenged to go ahead and look at a school systems issue here. They have a concern about low graduation rates among their high school students, and they want to look to see specifically which factors might be related to completion of high school. And so specifically, they're looking to see if two variables are associated with each other. Students obtaining a high school diploma, which is a yes, no answer. So two categories, two levels to that variable. And we also have another variable, the other variable that we're looking to correlate with or see if they're associated, guidance intervention plan, whether or not that was done. Again, yes or no. So both of those variables are nominal variables. Want to see if they're associated. So we resort to a non-parametric statistic, right? And specifically the chi-square test association. And so once you set up or you have your data set ready to go. It's a very simple data set, just two variables, 0, 1. 0 is not having it, 1 is having it. So you have to go down the data set. You can see how many individuals you have. And again, 0 would be no, and 1 would be yes. We can go check that out under variable view. And under the values, see 0 equals no, 1 is equal to yes, and that's one of the common sort of conventions in terms of assigning values to specific levels of on a variable. So we have 1,496 subjects, participants, data points. Each one either has a 0 or 1 on each of these variables. Okay, so let's go ahead and go to descriptive statistics, crosstabs. And I've already selected, but what I did essentially was just select the variables, put high school diploma, yes, no variable, again, two levels, two possible responses, the guidance intervention plan as well, selected phi and Cremaise V, chi-square analysis, under cells, put so that we can generate what's essentially a contingency table. We have the observed and expected values. We've selected display clustered bar charts, and so it's going to provide us a nice visual display, which is helpful. There were no changes under format. And then you select OK to run the procedure. And what we have here is, first off, we have a listing of the responses, what was expected versus what was observed. And you can see there is a discrepancy here between what was expected and observed, both on the kids who obtained their high school diploma and the ones that did not, in terms of the whether or not they had a guidance intervention plan. The chi-test results are also presented below that, and we interpret the Pearson chi-square. There's a value there, the chi-square value, the degrees of freedom, and then we get our significance test. And the significance value here is certainly less than 0.05, so we know that there is a significant difference between what was expected and what was observed. So there's definitely some significant difference here. Also, if you look at phi, you can see that our value is 0.5, so it gives you a sense of the level of association between these two variables. Okay, here you can go and you can take a look at the clustered bar chart, and it provides you, you can see here that the high school students who had a guidance intervention plan, there were much fewer of those that had it for the ones who did not graduate, right? Then there were much fewer that had it than did not have it, compared to looking over to the right to the kids who did graduate. There's a greater percentage there, kind of flipped, not as dramatic, but nonetheless flipped, greater percentage that had a guidance intervention plan versus those who did not have it. So we see that the kids who had a diploma tended to have a guidance intervention plan completed. Okay, so that's part of that assignment, and you can go through and make sure you run the statistics here and you can get a sense of the answers and sort of what's going on here for this part of the assignment. So the second part of the non-parametric assignment for this class, go ahead and open the second data set. And we have one value for that. And the question here that we're struggling to or attempting to answer is we want to know specifically if there is a difference in terms of AIDS or HIV cases that have been reported for a given county based on ethnicity versus what would be expected based on the population distribution, right? So we know X percent of the population is white, X percent is Hispanic, and so forth. So we would estimate that the number of cases would mirror that ethnic breakdown. And one way to determine that, to get a sense of that, is to use a chi-square. And so we can set that up pretty easily. So you set up your data set, you have your variable ready, again, just one variable here, and it tells you 0, 1, 1 being, well, actually not 0, 1, but 1 is white, 2 is Hispanic, 3 is African American. You can always go under the value labels and you can see what each value is equivalent to. I selected variable view, as you all know. By now, this should be second nature to y'all. And you go to non-parametric tests, legacy dialog, you can use chi-square, and you select over the only variable that's available. And then here under expected values, you're going to sort of select what would be expected given the population distribution along ethnicity. And so 570, 257, 45, 235, and 10 is what we'd expect here. Generate descriptive statistics. Go ahead and run it. We have a contingency table. You can see the expected versus the observed on the little bit more than 1,100 cases. And you can see that there's a discrepancy, especially looking at white and Asian Pacific Islander. Huge differences in terms of what was obtained versus what you would imagine, what you would expect to obtain given the population distribution along ethnicity. And so we look here specifically at the chi-square value, degrees of freedom, and the significance value that was obtained. The significance value, again, less than 0.005. So like I said, less than 0.05. So we would reject the null hypothesis in this case. And we could see here that, you go ahead and write up what you found here for this one. But I just want to make sure that you have a sense of how to run these, where to find all the dialogues in the graphical user interface and that you're all set to go. As always, this is pretty short, pretty right to the point, but as always, have any questions, go ahead and email me or give me a call, and look forward to getting your assignment submissions. This is the last assignment for the stats class, so wish you well with completing everything, and hope you got a lot from this class. And again, I look forward to hearing from you with any questions, suggestions, input. And final thing, please be sure to complete the assignment feedback, the course feedback survey for this class. It's very important to me that you do that and you provide feedback, suggestions, and so forth. Okay, thank you all very much, and have a good day or good evening, depending when you're watching this. Bye.